The Caribbean Council for the Blind, iCare Caribbean, was founded in September 1967. The council has a membership of 29 organizations in 22 countries and territories across the Caribbean. CCB iCare Caribbean represents Vision 2020, the right to sight in Antigua and the rest of the region. Over the years, the council worked with populations of various territories to prevent blindness and create opportunities for the more than 60,000 people whose sight cannot be restored. In September of 2010, its CEO, Arvel Grant, met with the Prime Minister of Antigua and Barbuda, the Honorable Winston Baldwin Spencer, and outlined how this project would have a meaningful impact on the lives of people who, through poverty, inadequate knowledge about the causes and symptoms of sight loss, and lack of access to services, are living with limited sight or blindness. The two men forged a formidable alliance backed by the cabinet, and words became action when the first phase of this project was launched at the Fines Institute.
I can recall some months ago when Arvel addressed the cabinet of Antigua and Barbuda on this whole initiative. He outlined to us the absolute necessity of Antigua and Barbuda coming on board and working with the CCB iCare Caribbean to get this program off the ground. It was fully endorsed by the Cabinet of Antigua and Barbuda, and I am delighted to see that some initiative leading to a wider program is being launched today. And I am even more particularly pleased with the fact that the Fines Institute was chosen as the launching pad, if you like, for this very important program in Antigua and Barbuda. This demonstrates that not only Arvel and his group, but taking into consideration where we are, that the individuals at the Fines Institute are not forgotten at all. You are considered to be very important, and it is felt that here is the best place to start this program.
The government is committed to ensuring that we give support by way of waivers of all duties, taxes, and any other charges which may be incurred with the importation of anything that is necessary for this program.
The Antigua and Barbuda CCB iCare project got underway in August 2011 with a two-day clinic conducted by Dr. Ang and a team of second-year optometry students from the optometry degree program at the University of Guyana. The team tested 69 residents, staff, and a few selected members of the public. The results confirmed CCB iCare's original statement that most people over the age of 40 have treatable sight issues.
Yeah, we have some encounter a lot for a kind of ocular diseases. That's I don't know if it's really due for the neglecting. So there are, for example, we have the cataract cases. So I think the cataract already stay long in the eye. So it's nothing. Maybe the ophthalmologist can see it if it still can prevent it through surgery. And then some, we have seen a glaucoma. So it's stage two. So maybe we have to prevent them because it's one of the cause for the blindness here. And some also have conjunctivitis. So maybe they have to prevent for our bacteria because they are, the nurse told us that it's the same ward. So maybe they are contaminated to each other.
69 people were examined. 45 needed prescription glasses. 10 needed low vision devices. 13 have cataracts. And of the remaining 14, 3 are blind and 11 have in most cases treatable eye diseases. It became obvious that for the residents, the team's visit was a positive event.
My reaction towards having this clinic here is immensely great. I lose the sight glasses and I bought a reading glass. And after that, I use a reading glass like for reading my Bible in the morning and in the evenings. Yesterday's eye care at this clinic was great.
3 months after the initial eye care clinic, the residents and staff were presented with their glasses. 38 very happy recipients. Alton Ford, the master of fines, spoke for all when he praised the CCB eye care team for such a prompt delivery.
This initiative, having been launched at Fines, represents another first in the many firsts for Fines Institute. Today, we will witness the presentation of 38 pairs of prescribed glasses to residents and staff of the Fines Institute. I wish to thank the CCB Eye Care Caribbean, especially Mr. Grant and his team, for the wonderful gift of improved vision for all those who will be the recipients of glasses today. Sight is extremely important to individuals' ultimate survival and well-being. Any initiative aimed at preventing blindness and visual impairment while restoring sight and creating opportunities for persons whose sight cannot be restored is phenomenal. I am indeed heartened for the alliance that has been formed between the Fines Institute and CCB. I welcome and applaud any initiative that will improve, enhance, and protect the health and well-being of residents and staff at the Fines Institute. I am particularly heartened and humbled by the presence of the Prime Minister, twice in a row now, and the Minister of Finance. The fact that they have taken time out of their very busy schedules to be here is testament to the government's commitment to and support of the work of the Caribbean Council for the Blind, Eye Care Caribbean, in Antigua and Barbuda.
I am feeling very elated having participated in this exercise.
Prime Minister Spencer could not hide his delight at the speedy delivery of this project and is looking forward to taking it across the Twin Islands state.
The government is committed to the program nationwide. We have started at the Fines Institute, but the whole idea is to extend this throughout Antigua and Barbuda. That is why we have already identified 3 clinics which will be considered vision centers, and those clinics will be serving the people of Antigua, and we'll be putting one in Barbuda as well, the 4th clinic. Whatever it takes for the government of Antigua and Barbuda to collaborate fully with this institution to ensure that we deliver on this promise of providing eye care for the people of Antigua and Barbuda will be done. The program will be fully developed to a point where the people of Antigua and Barbuda who need this kind of eye care service will have it available basically at their doorsteps, and that's the ultimate objective.
We're going to be putting in place a 3-lane eye examination lane eye clinic.
The funding for the capital equipment is coming from the European Commission, Sight Savers, and CCB Eye Care Caribbean. The government of Antigua is being asked to contribute building space, utilities, and a general waiver of charges and taxes on imports for the program.
In terms of the recurrent cost of making the thing run forever, it's going to have a cost recovery component to it.
The Ministry of Finance, the Economy, and Public Administration will certainly do everything as part of the government of Antigua to ensure the success of this initiative and to encourage you to expand it and to extend it so that this socially useful move can be spread to other members of the community and that others who are deserving may also benefit.
The future of eye health services in Antigua and Barbuda looks bright indeed, thanks to an innovative partnership between CCB Eye Care Caribbean and the government and people of Antigua and Barbuda. However, the last words belong to the first recipients, the very deserving residents of the Fines Institute.
We're feeling fine. I can see the world is much better now. Thanks, CCB, for doing this great work. Thank you.